Hey, Draken. How's it going, man? Good to see you. Alright, so, welcome back to the story mode playthrough of the Shu faction in Dynasty Warriors 8 Xtreme Legends. But we will be continuing from the Battle of Chibi. A reminder of a story. I said the story last time, so I'm just going to let it play out as normal this time. Just a reminder. So we get to this interesting point in the history of the game. This is a major turning point in the Three Kingdoms storyline. You know, Wei have their big army, we have to resist with their navy. Shu are just a little... Yeah, that's what it's called, Draken. Actually called the Battle of Chibi. Yes, that's correct. I know for you that has different connotations, but still. This also serves to remind me that it would be really cool if this was narrated by a voice actor. I still find it weird that in Dynasty Warriors 7 there was a voice acting over the narration, and in earlier Dynasty Warriors games there was a voice acting over the narration, but here they just don't bother. I don't know why. Did they not like the idea of having voice actors in these story scenes or something? Or could they just not be bothered? People don't like it when people talk in the narration stuff. So screw them. Alright, so this is the Battle of Chibi. This time though we'll be doing this from the Shu perspective, which will be slightly different from the Wu perspective. I mean, compared to Wu, Shu didn't bring as many troops to this battle, but they did bring Zuge Liang's plan, so... Anyway. Which of these three shall we play as this time? Since we have played as all three of these, I'm going to let the chat decide which character I shall play as next. And the chat may just be Draken, so... Who's it to be? The wise strategist himself, Zuge Liang, Zhao Yun, or Liu Bei? Which of these characters... It looks like Zuge Liang starts at his altar. But the other two start a bit further back in this case. So which of these three shall I play as? Zhao Yun, I like blue. Alright, well he was pretty fun to play as last time, so I'm sure he will no doubt be entertaining once again. So we'll go with Zhao Yun. I'm just going to check if he got any more weapons in that last fight. Oh, he did. Yeah, he did, but it was rubbish, so we'll sell that. Whatever. Alright then, so, let's go kick ass again with Zhao Yun.
I fight so that honor may carry the day.
Really? Honor, huh? The meeting of the minds.
So you are Master Zhuge Liang, the famed strategist.
Master Zhou Yu. All is as I outlined in the scroll I sent you.
Oh, so formal. We are to talk of fighting together. We must be more open. Isn't that right, my lord?
Exactly right, Lu Su. I read your scroll. A proposal that will certainly be of benefit to both yourselves and to us. Blunt Cao Cao's momentum, and buy us some time. Advantageous to us all. But that is not the entire story. Unlike Wu, Master Liu Bei lacks a land which he can call his own. Perhaps obtaining such a foothold is your true goal.
Come now. We cannot expect all secrets to be shared. Can we not turn a blind eye?
Well, this alliance would certainly be good for Wu. The battle shall take place at Chibi. We shall use our intellect and courage to sink Cao Cao's great fleet.
Zhou Yu is a perceptive man. I wonder how much he sees of the truth behind this alliance. But for now, this is the only path we can take. We must claim victory here first, before all else.
Forces have landed in the south. Oh wow, that was a strange cut there. I guess that was designed in case you played as a Zhu Ging in the arm. That was probably the best cutscene that Zhou Yu's ever been involved with. Alright, let's go. Oh, we have to stop them from getting to the altar. Oh yes.
Understood. I shall protect the both of you.
I'm going to have your
hand. Are you all right?
Yes. Thank you for your concern.
As you can see, Zhou Yu pretty much knows what to expect from Zhuge Liang's plan.
During the ceremony, not allowed any enemies to approach
the altar. No problem. What?
Please keep the enemy away from the altar.
I'm trying my best, dude.
I am resuming the prayer ceremony. Please do not allow the enemy to approach the altar.
There's no one at the altar, man.
Oh, you are quite impressive. I shall lend you a hand.
See? Not a single one. Oh, they got all these items.
We're not going to like the outcome of this encounter.
Oh no. Yu Jin. Nice.
How could I let them suffer?
Got him. Nice.
Another obstacle in the path of justice has fallen before me.
Lord Liu Bei, we are here to help. Together we can get through this.
Oh man.
Very nicely done. Keep up the good work.
I'm not letting a single one of these guys through.
You would face me in battle, would you? Very well.
We are almost there.
Nice, we got him. Awesome.
It appears that there are complications with the fire attack. Perhaps the enemy has seen through Hong Kong's plan to link their ships together.
Enemy ships are approaching the altar.
Uh-oh.
So you're the Duke of the Army that Shushu was talking about. I am interested to test the extent of your abilities for myself. You must be Cao Cao's new strategist. I hear that you possess an unequaled mind for strategy.
Ah, the first meeting of the two intellects, Sima Yi and Zhuge Liang. It's a very important battle they will have later on in Shu's story that hasn't been covered yet. Oh wow. Actually, now he's jumped down to here, which is pretty nice. Unfortunately, Sima Yi, your stupidity in this case is to be mentioned. You came a while, dude.
I can see that you are not a complete innocent. I look forward to our next encounter.
Alright.
That was an interesting duel. I shall remember you, Xtreme. That man mentioned the name of Shushu. As such, Hong Tong may also be in danger.
Come on, horse.
We shall go from ship to ship to work our way across the enemy fleet. We must help Hong Tong to ensure that the ships are linked together.
Ah, we got to assist Pang Tong, eh? Nice. Liu Su and Shun Shan Jiang are defending. Here we go. Alright, I'm here. Ah. We're waiting for our friends to show up, I see. Sweet. Just gonna quickly save there. Go on, guys and girls. Or guys in this case. Oh, this is cool.
We require two things in order for the fire attack to work. One is the southeastern winds.
Which we have.
The other is the linking of the ships.
I love those transitions, they're so good.
The ships is to prevent them from drifting apart. I entrusted that task to Hong Kong, but...
Really, Bang Tong's having a problem. No matter.
Somewhat pitiful, I agree. Thank you for the help.
Come and face me.
Oh, I missed him. Damn.
I'm being put on the defensive. I must fall back for the time being.
Ooh.
Another obstacle in the path of justice has fallen before me.
Oh.
Huh? What is Susu doing with South Tower forces? You can't proceed with a plan like this.
I see. We must defeat Shushu and ensure the success of our plan.
The weak ship plots. Okay. Let's go defeat Shushu then. So yes, in this version he joins up with Cao Cao.
Forgive me. I am a member of Cao Cao's forces now. I cannot let you pass here.
Yeah, he's wearing his green garb. Interesting that the picture of him had a green hood on, and yet here he has a blue one.
I have failed. I wonder where it is I went wrong.
Join the wrong side, buddy. That's what went wrong. Ooh, little trouble. We have three Muzu bars now, which is good. Here comes Captain Awesome.
You are doing an excellent job.
Oh yeah.
The ships are unable to move, and the wind is carrying the flames.
Oh wow. Their health is down to half. That's a nice touch. That's pretty cool. It's the first time I've seen that affect the enemy.
I suppose there are times when a little filial piety is necessary. As long as I am.
Get out of here. Whoa.
Magnificent job.
That was slightly glitchy.
I have underestimated.
Retreat. Launch the ships.
Oh. Oh, we gotta pursue his boat.
Where is Shushu? I hope he's alright. Do you not think that he would try to escape on his own accord? I imagine.
imagine he is probably still within the fleet.
Master Hung Dong of Sun Quan's forces has stopped Cao Cao's advance.
Nice. Oh man.
My lord, leave this to me. You flee to safety.
Tell me out. Thank you. I'll leave things here for you.
We have already taken measures against Cao Cao's retreat. For now, we just need to focus on the officers in front of us.
Witness my strength!
Oh wow, got away with that one. Yeah, we try and find Zhu Xu if possible. Would be handy. Yeah, they're all getting knocked down like Skittles now. Skittling the officers. Oh, here he is. Almost dead. Yeah, dude.
I hope you can find a way out of here as well.
Oh, good. Get out of here, Zhu Xu. Yeah. The morale's at maximum, so everyone's getting their asses kicked. Now he's gotta get Cao Cao. Really cool to see all these ships flying up and down as well. I could air juggle you all day. Wow. That's every single officer now defeated on the ships. It literally just is Cao Cao now. Now, Cao Cao is supposed to be able to get away from this battle, normally, as we have seen in the Wei campaign. Historically, he retreats from this battle, and it sets up the turning point for the historical and hypothetical for Wei. Oh.
Yeah, I'm going to squash you!
Come and face me.
Here comes the big guy.
It is impossible for an army to continue fighting on an empty stomach.
Another obstacle in the path of justice has fallen before me.
Hey, stop getting everyone's attention.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say that out loud.
Now it's my chance.
Boom. Will explosion, Strow. I hope you're happy, man. Oh, wow. My combo got interrupted.
Another obstacle in the path of justice has fallen before me.
Fire.
These flames shall be the beacons to light your way. We must move on, my lord. The next battle has already begun.
What? You're leaving already?
My apologies, my lady. I am sure we shall meet again.
So Yi Yong looks really evil.
My lord.
Ah, Xu Xu.
That day, when we first fought together, and now, seeing the battlefield from Wei's encampment, I realized that I have been lying to myself. The place I should be is here. I am no master of strategy, I fear. I am quite naive, in fact. Yet...
Make use of me, my lord.
Oh, God.
Wish to light your way to glory.
That is scary for some reason.
Well said. I have been waiting for you. From today, you walk with me.
Okay. The vigor of these great men was reflected within the river, as was their wisdom displayed by the flames that enveloped the battlefield. The alliance between Liu Bei and Sun Quan had earned a great victory over Cao Cao, leaving him with little choice but to halt his expansion south. Although, simply driving off Cao Cao was not the great leap forward that Liu Bei needed to take. Zhuge Liang looked for an opening within Wu and ordered his men to occupy Jing Province. Here we go with the Jing Province stuff again. Liu Bei asked to borrow Jing Province from Wu until he could obtain a land of his own. Although Sun Quan disagreed at first, he was later persuaded due to the intervention of Lu Su. Around the same time, Zhu Xu, who had advised Liu Bei at Xinyi, joined him. In addition, Pang Tong, Huang Zong, and Wei Yan came to serve Liu Bei as well. Yeah, this trio of characters are kind of interesting. I'll say no more than that. Looking to take the next step forward, Liu Bei continued to amass strength. In addition, as the relations with Wu continued to strengthen, marriage proposal was brought before Liu Bei. And so, Liu Bei was married to Sun Quan's younger sister, Shun Shang Jiang. Ah yes, indeed. I guess this is what an ancient Chinese wedding ceremony looked like.
A political marriage like this would be fraught with pressure.
You don't see as much as you think you do. Just take a good look at them. Those are the faces of young people in love. You Bei, happy. Excellent.
You might be right.
So far, all is according to plan. But my lord, the next step, I fear, will be the hardest for you to take.
That man is evil. I am convinced of it. 2 years had passed since Liu Bei obtained Jing Province. Cao Cao continued to expand his territory to the north, while Sun Quan solidified his hold on Jiangdong. Suddenly, the opportunity Liu Bei had been waiting for finally presented itself. He received a request for reinforcements from Neo Zhang in Hanzhuang, who had been attacked by Zhong Lu. Liu Bei saw this as a chance to enter Liu Zhang's territory of Bashu and seize the land for himself. If he could do so, then he could realize Zhuge Liang's plan to split the land into three kingdoms. Dividing the land into three, it was an ambitious plan for him to compete for control of the land together with Cao Cao and Sun Quan. However, would he be able to overtake his own relative Liu Zhang? Was that the path that he was destined to follow? While Liu Bei struggled with the decision, Pang Tong continued to urge him on for the sake of the land and its people. Once Liu Bei made up his mind, he advanced his army on Chengdu in Yini province. Together, Pang Tong, Huang Zong, Wei Yan, and Zhu Xu prepared for battle in order to find a land. Right. Okay, so At this point, this is where Shu do a lot of things. Now, it's commonly perceived in the lore that Shu are kind of doing it just for the people. In truth, Shu did a lot of dubious things, just like Wei did, just like Wu did. They were no better than the other two in some aspects. This being one of them. Basically going to war against your own relative just so you can have some fucking land to claim. Not the nicest thing. I'm starting to suspect I kind of like this Shu story so far for some reason. It seems to have a bit more something I like about it compared to the Wu one. Although, it's on par with Wei's at the moment, actually. Got some good cutscenes as well. Alright, so we have three new characters to pick from in the chat. We have the barbarian-like Wei Yan. Yes, he really does speak like you saw him in the cutscene all the time. He's like a sort of, well, he's basically like the ultimate warrior, I suppose, if you know wrestling. And that's what it, and that causes some problems later on. There's Huang Zhong, who is an old man and a very good archer. And Pang Tong, who is a very weird person who's mastery of the wind or something like that. Very strange guy. So which of these three new characters shall we pick from? Pang Tong, Huang Zhong, or Wei Yan? You make the choice, chat. Since we've already, we're not going to play as this guy since we've already played as him once before. So which one of these three characters shall we play as? Any takers? I think I might have done this map before, but I don't remember it. If so, it doesn't immediately jump out at me anyway. I'm going to use this time to slightly readjust the chat window. Don't mind me. There we go. I'm about to make a quick adjustment there. I can see the time a bit. Come on, someone in the chat. Anybody at all. Pick your character. Of the three new faces, who shall I play as? Is anyone actually in the chat? That might be a better question to ask at this point. Or is it still just Draugen again? Is Draugen going to be the deciding vote once more? Or are there other people? Ooh! I better check, actually. Let me see. Can I embarrass any workers into responding? Let's have a look. Aha! Tuau! Niskarin! This dude! All five of you! One of you must surely have a pick, an option. You've been called out. Now you must pick a character. It is the law. Or something like that. Ah, Tuau has been called to action. Hello there, how you doing? You go for Pang Tong. Right, we'll go with that. There's not many people around. We'll go for the first one. So, Pang Tong. How are you doing anyway, Tuau? I think you've been this, I think you've been around here before as a worker in the past. Sorry if I had to call you out, but I like the chat to pick characters. Is the thing. And hello! That's the spirit. Actually, switch to this weapon. Oh, okay. Whirlwinds. So he uses a fan. It seems. A shadow fan. Another one he uses a fan. Ooh, he has stormy fan. Ooh, that sounds good. Let's have that. This is his other one, which is super cool. So, I didn't know he used a fan, actually. The last time I played as Pang Tong, he used a stick. Actually, he used a staff. Not a stick, necessarily, so... Alright!
I'll do my best out there.
Pang Tong has a...
promising anything.
Sorry, I've been talking at the wrong time there. Pang Tong has a pretty important role in this map, actually. He has a pretty significant thing to do in this. So, this is a good pick, actually. Alright, so this is his move list, since I think this mission starts off after the cutscene we're going to get. It's usually the case when we get this option at the start. Oh, it just means a cutscene's going to play first, but whatever. So, his EX is the fourth combo, which is Brief Fire. The second one is Temporarily imbue your attacks with the element of fire. So Izmuzu is Sky Surfer. Dario is... So he seems to have command of the wind and the fire, apparently. Alright. Let's do this. Oh. We do get to go straight in. Cool. Good, let's sell some weapons. So I'm getting dangerously close to that limit again. There. Yeah, I'm really getting close to that weapon limit again. I have to still sell some more stuff. Strange man. Yes, indeed. Alright, let's go talk to some people. I feel safe when I'm near Zushu. I wonder why. I wonder why, too. Zuge Liang is also heading towards Chengdu. Things are looking good. Oh, sorry. The sweeping dragon is Zuge Liang, and the fledgling phoenix is Pang Tong. We are lucky to have these great strategists. Okay, so I'm known as the fledgling phoenix. Our lord is sure to prevail. The one called Ma Shao of Zai Liang has apparently sided with Liu Zhang. Ma Shao, huh? Things will get ugly if he appears now as reinforcements. Foreshadowing. Aren't Liu Zhang and Liu Bei related? I wonder if they could just share Chengdu. No, I didn't think so. Yeah. Fortunately, the path of benevolence dictates going against family sometimes, I guess. You are so straightforward, Master Liu Bei. I have to admit, at my age, it is almost irritating. But that's the best thing about you, Master Liu Bei. You understand that too, don't you? Liu Bei! Still doesn't have... a country. I... defeat... Liu Zhang, Chengdu will be Liu Bei's. Yep, he talks like that all the time. I think it's a speech thing, but that's how he speaks. Wang Zhang and Wei Yan are experienced officers. They're sure to help us in battle. Mm-hmm. I speak of benevolence, it attacked one of my family. Is this truly the path I should be taking? Yes. It is. Oh, here we go. It's this dude again. My lord, it's me, the man you saved. I just found out that I'll become a father soon. I wonder if it will be alright to build a house in Chengdu. It would be a nice place to raise children. I often expect to hear that he got divorced by the end of this. But anyway. The way Lord Liu Bei rules will surely please the people of Yi province. There's no doubt about it. Lord Liu Bei is clearly suffering. Is having the same name such a big deal? You're an idiot. I hope you... Killing his own family, man. I've been serving Master Liu Bei for many years. Finally, it's time to take our country. It's not your country. These two have studied tactics. It's great to see the number of strategists increasing. Oh. There's a new face. Yanzhu Garrison and Fu Castle are strategic positions. Attacking them will surely divert our enemy's attention. I recommend we work on capturing one of those first. Oh, I'm not familiar with this guy. The battle won't end if the enemy stays holed up there. Let's attack Yanzhu Fort and Fu Castle. That'll open up a shortcut to Chengdu. So how was your weekend then, Toao? Has it been a good weekend for you? This one is absolutely necessary in order for Lord Liu Bei to establish his kingdom. But there's something about this battle. It's not like the others we've fought. Yeah, he's fighting family. I wonder if we'll get to play as him later. I mean, there's new characters I'll be discovering in each of these factions. It's going to be fun to discover their stories and stuff. Alright, the time for talk is over! As is the time it's staring at the sky. It's time to fight. Hey, Ryan Knighton 101, thanks for the host. Is this really the only way forward, Pang Tong? You've got too close to Master Liu Bei. That makes you feel his pain too intensely. However, Master Liu Bei has no other choice. If he wants to obtain Yi province, he must even trample family, if that is what it takes. I fear this battle will be too much for him, though. It's alright, nothing much happened. How about you? I've had an alright week. Been working on my MVQ and pretty much just... It's been productive, but... I fear the busy times are yet to intensify over the next couple of weeks and months. And I have so many Doom mods to play now as well. I have so much to do, so many games to play. If you look in the channel description below, you'll see I have a lot of games and Doom mods to play. I am pretty much set for the next couple of years in terms of that. Anyway, Master Liu Bei making his stand will greatly please the people of this region. That's why he must do this. This chaos isn't easy to deal with, is it, Pang Tong? Won't we just work that out? Come on, let's go.
Okay.
Alright. Quick reminder and go.
Let's take Chengdu for ourselves. I'm counting on you,
everyone. Here's the EX1. Whoa, what the hell? Ooh, he can fly. What the heck? Win! He's a very slow character. I am surprised. Actually, I don't think... No, I don't think we've played this map before. So this is a new experience for me. Ow. Really, dude? Fire! Whoa! He gets stunned when he does his EX2. But apparently he can breathe fire. That's pretty cool.
I'll let you go for now. Don't think you won.
Hey, I defeated an officer.
Come forth. I shall teach you a thing or two about battle.
Wow. Whoa! Wow! He just surfed on his staff. I mean, fan. That's pretty cool. Awesome. He just surfed on his fan. That is pretty cool right there. Are you playing dumb, dude? Oh, I'm going the wrong way here. I went the wrong way here. Oops. I think.
If you keep this up, all will be well.
Not bad. I find your efforts to be quite impressive.
Yeah, he definitely gets dazed by that.
I'm feeling pretty good. How could my tactics fail like this?
Interesting.
Hey, I defeated an officer.
You should gotta take a breather after breathing fire, I suppose. Surfing Pang Tong style. Oh, I've been wounded. Oh no.
Still, I can't let injuries like these get the better of me. Not long until.
Ah yes, Pang Tong gets wounded in this fight. I also forget that he's kind of an older dude.
Okay, let's get this thing started.
Alright. The thing. Fire! Thanks, dude. That was actually quite useful. Surf's up, dudes. Surf's up. And destroyed. Time to keep going. This guy's got a pretty cool... This guy's a pretty decent character. Come on, dude. You can make it. I have faith in you, man.
Perfect timing. I was looking for an opportunity to test my new tactics.
It's actually combo's quite now. EX into his Muzu right there. Yeah. They also removes the stun that he has on his EX too. I wonder what's a strange thing to have though, having a stun on a character. Hello guys!
Now let's give the enemy something to chew on. Okay, let's get this thing started.
Ooh, frozen.
We enter. Hey, we managed to open the castle gates. I better pick up the pace.
Yeah, get in, dude. Get in.
You are doing an excellent job.
Whoa.
Hey, I'm doing pretty good. Let's see what you think of this.
Surf's up. Nice. And that takes care of the castle.
Our allies are due to arrive shortly. Well, well. We're doing even better than I anticipated. Guess I better hurry and
what the hell is that? So I'm this weird guy again. Fazom. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Whoops. I keep forgetting to look at the map, so it's like, whoa, man. So, are you a fan of the Dynasty Warriors series then, Tuwau? Hope I'm saying your name right. Tuwau? I assume you're a fan of Dynasty Warriors. Oh, they're surrendering to him. Wow. So they actually just surrendered to him because they liked it. Uh-oh.
What? Is this some sort of trap?
Yes.
You're just as gullible as your reputation
suggests. Uh-oh, Liu Bei's in trouble.
Everybody, I order you to slay Liu Bei.
Oh no. Wow. Liu Bei's been stuck in a trap. Well,
officer.
That's a pretty cool looking area. Oh, I need that. Uh-oh. Oh, a lousy ambush, huh? Got him.
Hey, I defeated an officer.
Huh. What's that drawbridge for then?
I'm sorry to have kept you waiting.
Oh, what do we have here? Catapults. Hell yeah.
The catapults are ready. Let us use them to break down
the I'm getting shoved by the catapult. Whee! I didn't move the control then, I was being pushed by the catapults. Ah, you're a fan of the classic series, huh? That's kind of an awkward place to have them though.
Don't push yourself too hard if you're in pain, okay?
Well, arrow wounds are bound to hurt. However, it's best if I don't speak.
Oh.
I am sorry to have caused you this trouble. I am only because of you.
I wish we saved him just as he was fine. That was a waste of time. Yeah, I used to play the classic games myself too well. I've not played a Dynasty Warriors game properly since 4, really. So, this is like... I saw 7, I liked 7. I bought a PS3 to play 7, but... The capture card I bought didn't quite work properly. There was a delay, a lag problem, which I wasn't aware of. Ooh. We'll get back to that in a minute.
Secure here, away from the fighting.
He talks of benevolence, and yet brings this destruction. The villain. Oh, enemy of justice!
Ah, young master! Let's go!
Oh boy. Machao and that guy, but I can't remember his name.
Now you face me. Spear shall strike down all evil.
Ah, Madai, that's his name. Tong's talking. He's like an old snarky wit or something. Surfs up, justice boy. Justice.
Master Liu Bei has his own ideas, and they just so happen to be different from me.
You also serve in the name of justice? In that case, I shall join you in your quest to right the wrongs of this land.
Oh. Machao has surrendered.
Young master, if that is what you desire, then it is my pleasure to join them as well.
And so is Madai.
Machao has defected to the enemy? What's he playing at?
Oh, he's scared. And win.
You are the last person I want to face as an enemy.
Going to face me. Step forward.
Getting hot in here. Is that what he just said? Getting hot in here? I didn't notice that until just now.
Hey, I defeated an officer.
They're gonna clear up the other side pretty quickly, I feel. Alright. Oh. There's a target. How many items dropped? It's crazy. But yeah, crowd wiped out. Takes so long to change his weapon, too. Breathing fire. What's not to like, huh? Alright. We're almost done here. I'm just gonna hold this battle off for a second and see if anything happens when Liu Bei comes near him.
generations to come.
That may be. Still, I have no choice but to continue.
Alright.
Let's see what you think of this.
I thought something might happen if Liu Bei, maybe it would stop him from fighting or something. Alright.
Lord Liu Bei has come to save us from this terrible war.
Hooray for Lord Liu Bei! Hooray!
They sounded nervous.
Master Liu Zhong, I'm...
Don't go feeling sorry for him.
Hmm?
Listen carefully. The people are happy to be your subjects. A benevolent man would go to them.
Oh God, his eyes.
Pang Tong.
The battle went well, at least. But as for myself, it looks like I misread the remainder of my life.
But if you were injured, why didn't you say?
My lord, let me take this chance to speak. There are times when it can be best to hide your true face. No matter what happens, you must keep showing the people a benevolent visage.
Enough. I understand. Say no more.
Yes. This is my final lecture. Fly high, my lord, to the very top.
And that was the end of Pang Tong. Although Liu Bei lost Pang Tong during the battle, forced Wu Zhang to surrender and obtain Ji province. After wandering the land for such a long time, Liu Bei had finally obtained a territory of his own. It was this action that helped realize Zhuge Liang's plan to divide the land in three. Liu Bei of Shu, Cao Cao of Wei, Sun Quan of Wu. Chaos entered an era of the Three Kingdoms. 2 years later, Cao Cao defeated Jiang Wu and gained control of Huanzong with Wei next to Yi province. In order to put a stop to Cao Cao's momentum, Liu Bei promised to return Jing province in exchange for Sun Quan's assistance. Sun Quan agreed to the proposal and set out to invade Wei's territory of Hefei. Coordinating his movements, Liu Bei mobilized his army to attack Huanzong. His plan was to attack Huanzong, drive out Wei in order to make it into a base for bringing an end to the chaos. Impressed by Liu Bei's aspirations, the valiant warriors Ma Shao and Ma Dai were full of fighting spirit. The veteran warrior Huang Zhong also eagerly made his way towards Mount Dingjun. Okay, so Liu Bei finally has his benevolent kingdom. Appear to be nice and kind, but actually you're just another dictator. No true words spoken by Pang Tong there, especially what happens later. Alright, so we have three new characters to pick from here. As from the last battle, we had the option of Huang Zong, but also we now have the option of Mr. Justice, Ma Shao, and Ma Dai. We saw quite a lot of in previous campaigns. It's that very distinctive voice, I guess. So, which of these three shall we play as then, Toao and anyone else in the chat? Who shall I play as this time around? Our second return to the Battle of Mount Dingjun. So yeah, I was going to play Dynasty Warriors 7 actually a couple of years ago to finish my story I was saying to Toao earlier. But the capture device that I have, an Elgato, it turns out that the PS3 has a delay of a few seconds. I could never overcome it. And by the time eventually I got rid of my PS3 and just decided to wait for the next one. So I was actually really pleased that Koei Tecmo agreed to put the games on the PC in the future. So I won't miss any more Dynasty Warriors games should I continue to play them. So in the PS2 era days, I used to play 3 and 4 a lot. Over a decade later, I come back to it now. And my god, have I really liked a lot of the improvements. There's a few things the game, the difficulty scaling is a bit weird still, but I like a lot of what the game's done over the years. You can always do better though. Alright, anyone in the chat still around? I need another character being picked here from these three. Don't make me call out any more workers. I will call you workers out. You will be embarrassed and you will have to pick a character. Don't make me do it. 7:04. I ain't got time for another hour yet. I don't actually know what point we're up to in terms of the story. I think we might have passed the point of the split. I think. I could be wrong though, but it doesn't matter because we won't know how to unlock the hypothetical route until we've done the historical to completion anyway, so it doesn't matter about conditions and stuff like that. We just need to keep playing. I'm actually enjoying the shoot campaign so far. Still, it's pretty good. That's that nice feel about it that's similar to Waze really. I always thought there was something lacking in Wooz. I don't know what. Oh, you're gonna pick for Ma Shao. Alright. We'll play as Ma Shao then, Mr. Justice. Ooh, we're nearly level 25. That means we nearly have everything. So as you might not be entirely surprised, he uses a spear. Range the 4th and 6th strong attacks by holding down the button. Oh wow, he actually has quite a few weapons. Huh. Yeah, alright, shut up, game. Excellent. Alright. Okay, so, Mr. Justice Man, let us go.
I refuse to yield to any who dare cross my path.
I think you might be meeting a certain familiar female here. Alright, let's sell some weapons, since we have a lot to sell. Okay, we managed to get down to 1100. Again, I think I might just do some off-screen selling of stuff, maybe. Used to be a thing I'll need to do. So here we are at Mount Sharkey, the shoe camp, for the great battle of Mount Dingjun. Let's go see how the shoe guys feel. Wu has agreed to fight Wei with us here in a Hefe, on the condition we return Jing province. I wonder if their plans will actually work. I've started to get worried. Well, you have more to worry about in the future. Huang Zong was established by Liu Bang himself, founder and first emperor of the Han. Occupying it will further increase your renown, Master Liu Bei. I'm totally not a devil in disguise, honest Liu Bei. It will also give us an advantage in our battle against Wei. We must take this land, whatever the cost. If everyone die! I don't like that. That guy has like the face of He looks nice enough, but he's really not as pleasant as he seems. Asking a benevolence facade, indeed. Wang Zong, Ma Shao, and Ma Dai. We have many interesting people on our side. You chose those three of all people? I'd have gone for Wei Yan myself, but whatever, dude. It is very sad that we lost Pang Tong at Chengdu. I'm remembering him now for some reason. So that was it, Pang Tong's glory. He was old, he had weird eyes, he could summon fire and wind, and then he dies. I have a feeling that saving Pang Tong will be one of the conditions for that hypothetical. Very similar to when, like, all the Wu people died, and if you managed to keep them alive, it changed things. So I think we'll be saving his life in the next, when the hypothetical one comes down. Anyway, charging our dough? No, that's too dangerous. Not wrong, buddy. Why am I so tired? I wish Wang Zong would tell me his secret. The enemy, Xia Hu Wan, apparently a master of the bow. Ah, don't mention that to General Wang Zong. He'll get all worked up if he hears about it. The enemy officer Xia Hu Wan also uses a bow, I hear. Let's see what skills this upstart has then. I don't have pride on the bow for these two. One of the key points of this fight, the archer fight between Huang Zong and Xia Hu Wan. Wei's main camp is located at the summit of Mount Dingjun. Just getting there will be exhausting. Having seen the justice of Master Liu Bei, I have sworn to fight alongside him. I shall put my strength to good use. He's a hothead, I'm the first to admit it, but I feel the same way. Eh? I want to fight hard and win this battle, not just for Master Liu Bei, but also for the people. He's calling Liu Bei a hothead, or was he referring to Ma Shao there, like in the... Was that like a fourth wall break there? Could have been. I dedicated my whole life to caring for horses. Just look at this steed. Yes, look at this steed. This not animated steed. Wait, I could walk through the horse. What? What the fuck? Dude, these horses aren't real. I mean, okay, if I approach them from the back, they suddenly become real, but... What the hell? I can walk through them. What? Oh, sort of through them. I am a horse. What the fuck? They don't move. What the hell? I'm a horse. I am Michelle. I identify as part horse. Oh my god. Oh, this would be so ridiculous. These horses aren't even real, man. Oh god. I'm having trouble drawing my bow. Maybe Huang Zong could help me if I gave him some paper. Oh. They're telling a joke. Draw, bow, paper. Oh, I get it. These horses aren't real. Oh, God. I feel sorry for the people going to miss that little hilarious moment. That Ma Shao and Ma Dai, who joined with Master Liu Bei at Chengdu. Apparently, they are originally from Liang province. I heard that Cao Cao took out their entire family. Their anger towards him must be quite something. I honestly thought at first these might be like fake horses or something. But no. Ah, that's a weird mistake. Yan Yan! Scourge of my Dynasty Warriors 3 playthrough back in the day. Way, way back in the day. Like, the first one I ever did. This bugger killed me on my first ever Let's Play of Dynasty Warriors 3. You can look it up if you want. Taking control of the peaks at Huanzong will put us in a good position to attack Wei. We must not let our lord down. Land is currently divided into three domains. Let's work hard in order to unify them. Indeed. It's me, the one saved by Lord Liu Bei! Here we go. So how you doing, dude? I've left my wife and child behind at Chengdu so I can go out to earn some money. After this battle, I intend to go to Farm Castle. Both Lord Liu Bei and my family are important to me. That's why I fight for them. You just said you're doing this for money, though. Oh, whatever. Battle 1 is hold up tightly at Mount Dingjun. If enemy reinforcements arrive, it will be difficult to take it. Yet we have to do so, whatever the cost. We must realize Master Liu Bei's world of benevolence. Zahu Wan is one of Cao Cao's most trusted men. They are sure to send in reinforcements to aid him. We are short-handed. Attack them before their reinforcements arrive. That seems to be the plan anyway, with our fake horses. I'm looking at this movement before the start, actually. I'm not so sure it's a good idea to interrupt the start conversations. I'm going to try and do this from now on. I'll look at this just before I start the fight. So he's got EX on the 2nd and 5th. Charge the enemy, 20 weapon with your head picking up, Thunder Slice, and Heavenly Spear. Got it! Right! With our army of fake horses, let us go charge up the hill. Or mountain in this case. The time has come. Start the attack! Understood.
We must capture Mount Dingjun if we are to take Hanzhong. First, proceed to the base at the foot of the mountain.
Trying to get out of our base, man. Oh, here we go. Alright, let's do it.
So, they've made it all the way to Mount Dingjun. Hey, everybody. Get ready to defend this place with all your might. An enemy trap has been discovered on the road above. We are certain to take heavy damage if we proceed any further.
Oh, Ballista, huh? Alright, easy X2. Not bad.
We must find an alternate.
Stop me if you think you can.
First of all, take control of the main base at the foot of the mountain.
Stop me if you think you can.
Come forth. I shall teach you a thing or two about that.
Nice.
Whoa, what an amazing fighter.
Damn, what a, yeah, that was supposed to be going to be a pain to deal with. Wow. Grabbed him. Not bad. Gotcha.
I fight in the name of justice!
The enemy is facing straight ahead. Let us take this opportunity to make for our team.
Oh, good. I kind of guessed this was the way to go, actually.
That mountain will be ours in no time. Let's finish this battle! The enemy tried to take the mountain. They won't get tired here as long as I'm still standing. Burns with passion. That's enough. You're better than I thought. Good job. Come on, what are you waiting for? Let's get this fight started.
Oh. His move set is surprising. He's got a bit of a slower swing than I thought he would, actually. Getting that second EX attack is not hard. I didn't mean to do that. Or whatever. It's right, you gotta wait just a little bit longer than you might think to do it. His swings are basically slower than you'd think. Which is interesting. Oh, I got interrupted there.
Let's finish this battle.
Alright.
Let's finish this battle.
Down you go.
Display of skill. We shall fight again.
I fight in the name of justice.
Charge.
I have come to lend you my assistance. Our Lord's troops will also be arriving shortly.
Stop me if you think you can.
You are unstoppable.
Young master, the land is yours for the taking.
They are pushing quite a bit. Wang Yi. Nawasu has Stockholm Syndrome with Ma Xiao. Hey, 109 Boats. How you doing, man? Good to see you.
I fight in the name of justice.
Not this time, m'lady. You'll have to wait a little bit longer to get your revenge on Ma Xiao. Good job, Xiao Yun. Ooh, baby. Oh wow, so I took it again. Wow. Killed him quick. All that blue stuff, I think it's because of his weapon, nothing to do with the natural ability of Ma Xiao. We've almost capped at the summit. So. Nice.
Stop me if you think you can. Let's finish this battle.
Got him.
Good. You have taken Mount Tiandong. Now, I would like you to launch a surprise attack on the one you can.
Ho 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 ho.
Say, we've got a perfect view of everything that's going on in the enemy camp. I'll be able to take them down with you.
The poke stick. Ooh. What are you doing, Wang Song?
Amazing. You sure know how to fight.
What's this? Huh? What am I?
Our forces here seem sufficient. It should be enough to keep them occupied.
It appears that the enemy is using this battle as a decoy. They must have their eyes on something even bigger than Hanzhong.
So what's happening here then? We can't actually seem to go down this way. What the fuck? I don't know what's going on here, guys. Oh! What the fuck? What the hell?
They're charging down the mountain.
Oh, I'm supposed to press strong attack. Okay.
I shall eliminate the Wei Vanguard by myself if I have to. Well, you're about to become another one of my
conquests. That was so... Yeah, janky as hell. Well said, Ghost.
Can't let him see me fail.
So, what am I gonna do?
Another character I'm not familiar with. Zahu Bar.
You are unstoppable.
Barb is here. I assume he means Zahu Wan.
Let's finish this battle.
My spirit burns.
burns with passion.
Wow, nice miss.
Let's finish this battle.
This isn't looking
good. Got him.
They will need me in the next fight. Sorry, but that is all for today.
Okay, we gotta defeat Cao Cao now.
The land is yours for the taking.
It's good.
You're better than I thought. Good job.
I guess I didn't play as Zahu Bar in the Wei campaign. I must have missed that. Oh, unless he's not Wei. Maybe he's Jin? I guess we'll find out when we play as Jin next time around. I keep forgetting that a lot of Wei people join Jin or whatever. We know. Justice, justice, justice. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm gonna go in here just for some reason. Oh. There was no like, here's our secret ambush unit. What discovered? Oh yeah, you keep it shut tight, man. You did all you want. Oh, let's do some rage. I thought the rage were a couple of characters, am I? Unstoppable.
I would be honored if I could test my skills against you.
It's everything to him, yeah, I know. Tidal wave of bodies. Justice.
Mm-hmm. I must return while I am still able.
I never imagined that Liu Bei's forces would grow so powerful. However, I refuse to let him stand in my path of conquest.
You dare stand before me? You shall pay for your audacity.
Burns with passion. I am Li Dian, your worst nightmare.
Justice by mass murder.
Just not my day. I'll come back again when I'm feeling better.
I fight in the name.
What a weird
justice.
Ability that is.
I must pull back here, but my ambition is not yet extinguished.
That is a weird move that Fa Zheng does. It's so strange. Yeah, tidal wave of bodies, justice by mass murder. Yeah. That was so strange. The Shu forces emerged victorious from the Battle of Mount Dingjun. With this victory, Shu gained control of... Oh, thanks. I didn't chance to Panzong. Yeah, thanks. I knew the worst time I juggle. Oh, dear God! Meanwhile, within Jing Province, Guan Yu, remember him, mobilized his army towards the battle lines in Huanzong. Jing province had always been precariously balanced. You don't say. Once Liu Bei had captured Jing province, Liu demanded he fulfill his promise and return Jing to them. However, Guan Yu, who had been placed in charge of Jing province by Liu Bei, stubbornly refused to hand it over. A crack had developed in the relationship between Xu and Liu. At that moment, Guan Yu led his children into battle to attack Wei's stronghold of Fang Castle. His move was like a blade aimed straight for Cao Cao's throat in his location at Xushang. The situation grew more tense by the instant. The gaze of Wei and Liu was firmly fixed on Guan Yu's actions. However, it was all an effort to deliver the land to his sworn brother, Liu Bei. The god of war, Guan Yu, along with Guan Suo, Guan Xing, and Guan Yinping, was in high spirits as he prepared to attack Fang Castle. No, not this fucking map. Oh god, do I hate this map so fucking much. Not again. Ugh, I thought we'd skip this map with Xu. But no, we're gonna be playing as it. Ah, god damn it. I don't like this map. This map has been a pain for me both as Wei and as Wu. Maybe it will be better with Xu, I don't know. Oh god, I'm not looking forward to this. Anyway, we are playing as Guan and his kids, basically. So we've already played as Guan Yu, so we get to play as one of his kids. So chat, so we play Guan Suo, his son, Guan Xing, his other son, there's also Guan Ping as well, I guess, but he's not a pickable character. Or, do we play as his daughter, Guan Yinping? Doesn't have the beard of her father, she has his hair instead. So we had the choice of his kids. Who shall we play? What are the weapons? Oh, we can have a look at the weapons, I suppose, if that's the factor 109. So who's going for Guan Xing? Guan Su uses a nunchuck. Guan Xing uses a wing blades? Well, daggers, I guess. And Guan Yinping uses a dual stone mace. It's kind of like a twinned mace. So, mace, daggers, and nunchucks. Anything in pairs, really, seems to be their thing. None of them seem to take up the mighty halberd unlike their father. They all went different ways on weapons. Oh, look at that. She's cutely waving to us. How intimidating. How adorable. Alright, so Guan Xing getting a nod. What about you, 109 votes? What do you think? Anyone else? These are the three we're going to pick between. Oh, we're playing as Guan Xing, it seems. I did want to try out Guan Yinping. Her moveset seemed interesting, but I guess another time. Alright, Guan Xing, you're up. So, why is it the enemy while gliding through the air? That's cool. Daggers, yeah. Wing blades. Yeah, I know, shut up, game. Ooh, this one has a lot. Oh, I've got Earth, haven't I? There we go.
I will do what it takes to lead us to victory.
All right, Guan Xing. Do what you must, man. Meanwhile, in England, always rain.
The enemy are scouting frequently. Their main force will attack soon. So they let us take the castle before surrounding us. Have we just been dancing to their tune?
This never-ending rain, too. They surely plan to make use of it.
Huh. It's okay. We can win. So long as we all fight together.
I have shared my brother's ambition, and now I have seen my children grow so strong. Though I have lived through chaos, what a full and satisfied life.
Who did Guan Yu marry then? I wonder.
Father, is something the matter?
My children, your era. A new land of benevolence lies before us. Now, your honor and courage will be needed more than ever.
Wow. All right. Here we are. Yep, here we go. So, here we are at the Fong Castle. On you. Again, good thing we're selling a bunch of these. Alright, 109 votes, I'll see you in a little bit. There we go, that's more gold for the pile. So as you can see, Guan Yu has raised quite the family here. He has three sons and a daughter. I wonder who the lucky lady was. Guess we'll never find out. Let's look up his biography or something. Lord Guan Xing can appear a little vacant, but that doesn't mean he isn't thinking. He has true foresight and instantly knows what needs to be done. It might be hard to see, but he's a genius, no doubt about it. Foresight, huh? Cool. Guan Yu has many children. From eldest to youngest, there's Guan Ping, Guan Xing, Guan Suo. Oh, and he has a daughter, Guan Yinping. It's hard remembering their ages, let alone their names. Well, just start with Guan and go from there. I think I'll have the same problem, though. The only son I always associated Guan Yu with in the past was Guan Ping. But I guess his family expanded in this game. Lord Liu Bei always talks about the people he failed to save during the Yellow Turban Rebellion. He still talks about it as if it happened recently. He is such a benevolent person. Oh, yeah, sure he is. I think he's about to become a lot less benevolent in the future for a certain thing that will happen possibly after this fight. Lady Guan Yinping gets her strength from her father. I've seen her take out a stone wall more times than I can count. I've also seen some of the men picking up the fragments afterwards. They make protective charms out of them, apparently. Wow, that's... yeah, I'm sure that's the reason why they do it. Guan Yu is indeed a mighty warrior, but things like Zhu Province happen. I know, there's no point in thinking about what happened. Perhaps it's the rain that made me think about it. After what Mount Dingjun ended our victory, we can now expect reinforcements to come. But will they arrive on time? That's the question. Don't you remember me? It's me! I just came here from Mount Dingjun. I'm exhausted. I'm probably the first one to arrive. Everyone else should be arriving soon. Dang, you're a fast runner then if you're on your way from Mount Dingjun, especially since it's so far away. Props to him for being an athlete, apparently. The Usain Bolt of ancient China. Achoo! Ugh, I must have caught a cold after being exposed to all that rain. Never come to the UK then. Wow, these guys are all the way at the back here. These guys are the smart guys. They're like taking cover from the rain. These guys deserve a promotion for using their intuition. Guan Yu and his family should run a business. He can make his kids work for free. Low labor costs. No, we need them all out on the battlefield. Don't give him any ideas. Are these the bad joke duo? Ah, thanks for the other host, Lord Misfit. nice tree. Alright. I hope this rain doesn't take part in this battle any further. Oh, for those who have seen the previous two faction playthroughs, you all know what happens here. For those who don't, the rain plays a part in this fight, but you'll see how in a moment. Pang Tong's calm tone will be dearly missed, especially during these troubled times. His death at Chengdu cannot be reversed. We must all fight to avenge him. I think we'll probably find it can be reversed, but only via the magic of what if. Zushu's strategy has always proved effective in battle. He is very reliable. Zushu has decided to side with us after Chibi. This is a very big game for us. Thanks for the update there. Two battles after. Oh, she's adorable. That's a face. She's like the strong version of adorable, this character. My father and brothers are here. We'll turn back these enemies, no problem. I'm not sure why though, but this rain gives me a really bad feeling. You'll be fine. Or will you? This map gives me a bad feeling. How awful it is. Or at least it has been for me. As soon as the castle attack ends, we'll then have to defend it. By my honor. This isn't going to be easy on you. The field of battle is the true home of a warrior. Come, my sons. Let us prove our righteousness in this battle. And daughter, don't forget you have a girl in your family. If we drive off the enemy here, then we will capture Jing Province. I need to use my strength to bring victory to my father and to Shu. Mm-hmm. Alright. Let's take a look at that move list real quick. Three levels off the third alternate Muzu. So EX2, make a leaping charge forward. And wing blades, and we see Storm White combo on midair. Muzu attack is Sky Slider, which is circles with gliding through the air. And the aerial is Wind Rider. So this guy likes to ride with the wind, bullseye. Apparently. Alright, let's do this, and please, please don't be a pain in the ass like you were for the Wei and Wu playthroughs. Let's have a good time this time, shall we? Now is the time to strike. Let's go, brother. I'm with you, Guan Xing. Let's show them what the children of the God of War can do.
Everyone, keep up the fight. We must seize Jing Province in order to
establish. Whoa, those are some huge blades. Jesus.
Although we're in a bit of a tight spot, we refuse to surrender. Let's use our might to clear a path before us.
Alright, we're going to set the. So here's the second EX. Wow. This guy is flying around the battlefield like crazy. He's like Xiong He.
There is no escape.
Bloody hell, it's like a bird. It's a bird, it's a blade! No, it's Guan Xing.
How could my tactics fail like this?
What?
You had in the name of my father.
You had tactics? That does surprise me. Where's he going?
I have opened the floodgates. May you drown in the raging currents, Guan Yu.
Oh no. Oh no. The flood attack has decreased.
I cannot believe that I let them carry out their flood attack. I shall never live down these dictators. You have no choice but to abandon the castle. Everyone, begin the retreat.
I shall keep the enemy in bed. Father, you and the others make your escape.
Good work, Guan Ping.
Stay safe, my son.
Uh-oh. This is looking bad. Just like every other time we're on this map.
No, we mustn't think about that. And concentrate on our retreat for the time being.
Yeah, you focus on the retreat, man.
You will not get past me. Prepare to meet your death by my blade.
Come on, horsey. Absolutely not.
Come on, what are you waiting to see your weakness?
Let's get this fight started.
Interesting bird-like attacks here.
You are not going to like the outcome of this encounter.
Oh god.
There is no escape.
We're being mauled to death. Da 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 da.
There is no escape.
Oh man, one thing's been killed.
There is no escape.
Everyone, we must get out of here alive.
Oh boy. Every time I play this map, it's always about precision. And not in a good sense either. As we actually see what I was doing. At least this time all the objectives are right next to each other. Just die, thank you.
You fight just like our father.
Yeah, right. At least the good news is all the Wu's conditions are with me. It's not like the other two would have miles away. So it's a little nicer at least, but it looks like this battle was associated with just pain and suffering. We don't care about any of these guys. Good for you. Let's get out of here. Oh, I think I know what's going to happen here. I'm not spoiling it, though. I know exactly what's going to happen here. Note the position where we are now.
We're almost there. The escape point lies just ahead.
I'll let you go for now. Don't think you've won.
Da 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 da. Yeah, da 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 da. Here comes Wu. Okay.
I have come to assist you. You can escape this way.
We cannot afford to be defeated here. We must hold out for the sake of my fallen brother and everybody else.
All right.
I can anticipate your moves.
Come on, what are you waiting for? Let's get this fight started.
I am the Phoenix. And I've killed about half the wave forces. I think. Oh, we better move.
What is the meaning of this?
That was a pretty cool rage attack. He just flew through the air like a bird. What's going on? Wumong is like just behind us. Stop running! Stop it!
Guan Yu! You think you're so tough, but I am here to take your head!
I
refuse to take orders from you any longer. The time has come to repay you for treating me so badly.
Uh-oh.
I thought it's trade, father. I must do whatever it takes.
Oh man, this is just getting worse and worse.
Reinforcements have arrived from Mount Dingjun.
A bit late.
Everyone has already been forced to flee. Seems as though we arrived too late. It seems Wei used a blood attack against our forces. This will impede our progress as well.
There is no escape.
Come on, what are you waiting for? Let's get this fight started.
There is no escape.
It's getting pretty intense, but at least everyone is together. So, it's not as bad as it could be.
There is no escape. I fight on in the name of my father.
Ooh, his moves are a little awkward. But nice.
You fight just like our father. I shall be your opponent.
He jumps around a bit.
You're actually a lot stronger than you look.
I see your weak point.
You know how to fight.
Got it. Got it. Oh, we need to move again, guys. Wow, this is pretty intense.
It must be obeyed.
Oh no.
Prepare to fire on Guan Yu.
Now what? Man, we just can't get out of here, can we? And they're attacking with the worst thing possible. Fucking Ballista.
Xu Huang, are you so focused on vigor that you are willing to fight without honor?
Yep.
You came to save me. Thank you, brother.
Screw these Ballista. Ugh, I hate these things. Why does this map have to be the... This map is annoying me, even though it's not going as bad as it could have been. Get out of my way, you stupid Ballista. Thanks, Yu Guan Yu. Ugh. Time to go mad again.
Anticipate your moves.
You fight just like our father.
My Guan Yu turns into a friggin' phoenix when he wants to. News to me, pal. But who am I to argue, eh? Well, that took care of a good chunk of them. Now to defeat the reinforcements. Especially this guy.
There is no escape.
Wuzhong's still alive somehow.
There is no escape.
This isn't over yet.
No, he's not.
I shall devise a new strategy.
He's done.
I fight on in the name of my father.
Oh.
Excellent display of skill.
I was
careless. We shall fight again.
He drops his normal move similar to Yue Jin. But he's much less annoying. At least.
I'll let you go for now. Don't think you've won.
Nice. Got him. Ah, good. We're almost there, I think.
Personally ensure your death.
Uh-oh. Oh, sorry. All their health is good. Oh, here we go again. And see me easier as well. Oh, man.
Escape.
You wait up.
You're actually a lot stronger than you look. You're a lot smaller than
you. I am proud to have there such no a escape.
You sure know how to fight.
See me dealt with.
You must hold back. There's no escape.
You
Got him. All right, good.
You fight just like our father.
Oh,
this is as far as you go. My blade shall be the last thing you see in this life.
Oh man, now it's Sao Ren's turn to walk it off.
I will find a way out of here. Now, you're cut open a path to safety.
I will defeat you to ensure everybody can anticipate.
Rage time. Oh man, I didn't quite finish him off. Welcome back, we're on 9 boats. He joined us for this map I have despised in the past. Doing pretty well this time though, that being said. Gonna wrap this shit up.
There is no escape.
Man.
There is no escape.
I have not gained the right target here. Get out of here, Dog Shell. Thank you.
I fight on in the name of my father. There is no escape. Your force is filled with holes. I see your weak point.
Too many points where the enemy can attack. Keep switching out a lot, Sauron.
I was careless. There is no escape.
Got him. I think they did vote, you're right.
Impressive, God of War. But you are finished. Taking your head will mean far more than Jing Province. Father! Father, leave this to me.
Sorry, my son.
He has knocked him out.
I have said my goodbyes.
Yes.
Tell my brother that I am sorry.
Yes.
Father, wait!
Be strong, my daughter. Go, my children.
Passed on to the next generation. Impressive indeed. God of War.
The fuck? That somewhat ruined that pretty awesome cutscene right there. Just having him stand there with his eyes closed. My peer didn't save me. And one more thing to my brother, I ate his loaf. Oh, wow. The Shu campaign certainly is throwing some nice surprises. That's for certain. Definitely. The Shu forces managed to overcome certain defeat at Farm Castle. However, there was a heavy price to pay for its victory. The God of War was slain in battle. The extraordinary hero, Guan Yu, fell at Farm Castle. Behind it all was an agreement between Wei and Wu to conspire against Guan Yu in Jing Province. Wei feared Guan Yu's advance north and offered Jing Province to Wu in exchange for its cooperation. Upset with Shu for occupying Jing Province, Wu quickly agreed to the proposal. Wu dissolved its alliance with Shu, invaded Jing Province in order to sway Guan Yu. In this way, Guan Yu was defeated and Wei gained momentary peace while Wu obtained the lands of Jing Province. Amidst the chaos, the land found itself divided into three. It was a dangerous predicament for all concerned. Except for that bit in the far top right for some reason, which doesn't have any tongue claiming it for the moment. Strangely enough. With each kingdom having its own design for the land, there would be countless turmoil to follow. Just then, sad news found its way to Liu Bei, Chengdu. Oh. Oh boy.
Brave children, where is your father?
Father said to tell you that he was sorry.
No, Guan Yu!
My lord!
Not now.
Please! Zhang Da of Zhang Fei's forces has turned on us! He and his men have slain Master Zhang Fei and joined with Wu!
I didn't know about that.
No. Not Zhang Fei.
Dang, both his brothers killed.
Wu has shown us their true colors. My lord.
You're still an asshole, Judy Leon.
My lady, forgive me. I fear this will be hard on you. Yet, I no longer have any choice. We must defeat Wu and Wei and rule this land. That is how I shall honor my fallen brothers.
Dang, man. Previously, he had sworn an oath in the Peach Garden to his two sworn brothers. He vowed that even though they were born at different times, they would... Thanks, game. I really like it when you skip this. Again. They would remain brothers. However, in addition to Guan Yu's death at Farm Castle, Zhang Fei was also slain by a group of his own men. I didn't know about that, actually. New to me. Liu Bei was alone, felt deep sadness, uncontrollable rage. Shortly thereafter, Cao Cao of Wei also died, leaving his son Suitepee to rule in his stead. The Han Emperor then abdicated the throne in favor of Suitepee, who named himself the Emperor of Wei. Upon hearing this news, Liu Bei named himself Emperor of Shu in order to carry on the Han legacy. With the advent of the new year, Liu Bei declared his intent to avenge his sworn brother by attacking Wu. He refused to listen to the advice of his chancellor, Duge Liang, led his army to war. Protecting Liu Bei was Xiao Yun, along with the descendants of his sworn brothers, Zhang Bao and Guan Xing. With the sadness and anger of Liu Bei realize its quest for vengeance and Yi Ling? Well, that was a huge turning point there. A huge turning point. Wu betrayed the alliance, Guan Yu fell, left the family fatherless, and a leader without his two sworn brothers. Dark times. Dark times. Ah! So this was the turning point. Oh no! That means we're gonna have to play this map again! But for the hypothetical route. I see. Okay, so we've already done it at Mount Dingjun. So that's one west we have to do for later. There's two on Chengdu. Oh, we also did the Chibi stuff. That's good. We found Zushu. Okay, cool. That's good. I kind of figured that was a good thing to do. So we've actually done several of these already. So we're not doing too bad on conditions. We've managed to do two of them by just playing normally. But yep, this was the turning point. The Wei, it was the Battle of Chibi. The Wu, it was the Battle of Hefe. And for Shu, Van Castle. I figured this might be the point. So from here on out, it's the historical route. He goes to war with Wu to get vengeance for his brothers. Yeah, you did. You'll have to catch it on demand, 109 volts. You'll have to catch it on demand. Alright, so that's going to be it for tonight. Have you all enjoyed the stream? A few of you would have chosen to watch this. And I have to admit, I've really been impressed with the Shu campaign. I feel they put a lot of effort into it, you know. The Wu campaign was decent and all. But I felt it was lacking, whereas Wei's campaign felt pretty solid with good cutscenes, and I feel the same way with Shu. Some excellent stuff so far. It's been really cool to play through them. And I think the best is yet to come, because, fingers crossed, there are two missions that I'm hoping will crop up next time around that are really cool missions. I'm hoping we'll get to see two certain missions next time. One in particular, in fact. But we shall see if that happens. I'm not sure when the next stream's going to be. I might do one tomorrow night. I might not. I'll try and continue this in the next couple of days. Hopefully I'll do one tomorrow night. But if not, it'll be sometime in the week. So yeah, I hope you've all enjoyed this, all five of you. Thanks for watching, and have a good evening. Oh, and I started to do the Iron Man of Batsan X at some point, too, so I need to get up on that. Good night, everybody. Have a good evening.